and Meridian Behavioral Health Center helps men and women ages 18 and older with chemical dependency issues through multiple therapeutic treatments.
Okay, so we interviewed Officer Plants here at Eastview, and one main question that we asked him was what he thinks the most harmful drug is, and he didn't have a direct answer. It was more like it depends on the drug and depends on how much that person is using it, because they all have different effects depending on the person, especially if they're using other things with it. And then we also asked him our driving question, which was how to stop the spread of illegal drug use. And mainly he said just to enforce the laws differently, so that's not really something we can control, that's more of like the police, I guess. But also spreading it around the community, just trying to get your peers and your friends to stop using.
Okay, so our second interview was with Dr. Hack, and he's a neurologist at the Health Breakfast Neuroscience Center in St. Paul, and he's a graduate from the University of Minnesota, and he explained to us that, because we asked him how, like, what does the brain look like on drugs, and he explained to us that since the brain regulates all of our bodily functions, and it's the most complex of our organs, that drugs directly affect 3 areas of brain, being the cerebral cortex, which is the front part, and that part controls your 5 senses as well as decision making, and then the brainstem, which is like back here, and it controls your breathing and sleeping, and the limbic system, which is kind of like in the middle of your brain, and that helps regulate and control your ability to experience pleasure, which is kind of how people get addicted to drugs, because with repeated drug use, it disrupts your naturally well-balanced brain, and over time, it makes you dependent on it to receive the pleasure. And he also said that there's no magic number that triggers addiction in people, because everyone has a different bodily makeup, and how like one person could get affected by the same drug within a day, and another by a week.
This is our video.
I think Xans are harmful. I think people are dying from us. Glorified so much in the media, I think it could be prevented. And if people knew the effects and the causes of it.
once or twice, maybe.
Couple. Know that it is very beneficial to say which one is the most harmful when all of them can be impactful to somebody, right? I think if you're looking at the strict potency levels, we're looking really significantly at prescription pills, opioids, fentanyl, carfentanil. Mere grains of carfentanil is enough to kill a human being. And so when the cases like Prince, where he overdoses on a minimal amount and it really impacts somebody's body system and shuts it down to the point that they stop breathing and die, that's significant. If you have heroin where their body systems, they take too pure of a dose and their body system shuts down and they need Narcan to come back or potentially pass away, that's impactful. Same thing for meth and cocaine and all these other drugs. It's important to recognize that all of them are different and all of them impact somebody in a different way leading up to death.
All right. So some risk factors is worrying that most peers use drugs, which isn't okay. And if your parent or yourself is worried about it, to do some surveys from your school. If there is more aggressive or more off behavior than usual, be willing to offer help. Surveys will help others, parents, siblings, or you know what current teens do use drugs or how much they know about the dangers of their actions. Being willing to offer help by telling an adult or trusted teacher or their parent will help a student or anyone that has a new, more aggressive behavior. Some protective factors is having more school programs talk about substance abuse during school or even programs for after school. It can help kids understand the seriousnesses with drugs and how impactful they can really be. And then a positive family environment can help by bringing some families closer together. Might not always be like really easy or possible, but if you have a great group of friends who can be there for you, get you help and spread love, that's all you need. But also having good ways to deal with stress is a healthy way to work things out mentally. Some solutions is having flexible working schedules during your school day will be possible to have kids who need or want to learn more about substance abuse with drugs will be possible. And people who have overcame addictions can come and talk about their past. And then mental breaks, so having a couple minutes at a time each day to like relax and breathe with like stress balls or like breathing exercises can help a lot. And then our first choice solution is having it be mandatory to participate in two school activities for graduation. Counselors and teachers will support this idea. They might even recommend students who they see are not going through a great time and could use emotional and physical support from our great new friends. And then, it can help others be more out there and encourage students to step out of their comfortability level physically so they can reach new limits. We chose this as our first solution since it's the most prevalent to students and it could help others not be as lonely or alone as some high schoolers feel at times. They can feel a part of something and there might be some obstacles like having a job right after school that they need to get to, but we could work around it by having the mandatory activities only be like a couple days a week, not every day.
Okay, some apps you could use is, one of them is Clean Today Drug Free Life. Is an app to help you beat your drug addiction. It also gives you positive messages every day. And then another cool thing is that it like has a daily tracker so it can keep reminding you how many days that you are have been drug free. And then No Drugs is a way to keep you safe because it allows you to like check if something you think is a drug or not a drug. Like it basically just tells you if it is, and then if it is, it tells you like what it is and all everything about it. And then it works. And then another one is RCMP drug awareness. And that's good because it tells you all you need to know from like the definitions to like telling you about myths versus reality. And then it also has a section that talks about prevention.
One thing you can do to take action to help benefit your life and the chances of not using drugs is to join a club. In general, getting involved helps people to meet others and with the same interests and helps you to make new friends. Another action step you can take is to help encourage drugs, then you won't feel as pressured to do them as well. Lastly, by getting active will help to improve your mood so you won't feel the need to use drugs to make you feel better. It is also so much healthier overall to exercise instead of using drugs.
Okay, one last activity that we have is, so we're gonna put like a few definitions up on the board that describe like a drug, and then you're gonna have to guess which drug it is.
I need to start. I've waited too long. Money spent. I don't know how much that is.
Okay, so here are the symptoms for the first drug. So one symptom is red eyes, dry mouth. It affects you right away. And there's many different forms it can be taken. So, so the next one, it helps your anxiety. It is often very used. It comes in pill form and it can also make you drowsy or dizzy. It helps your concentration. It's used for ADHD treatment. It gives you better organization and listening skills. Okay, the answer to this one is Adderall. Okay, the fifth one, it's highly addictive. Like you can get addicted after the first try. It gives you confidence and energy. You have many mood swings, and you're unable to sleep. Okay. This one is math.
Drugs, and now you have some background knowledge for the next time that you are faced.